Gentlemen, please welcome Chuck Owen and the Jazz Surge. Thank you.
great to see you all. It's wonderful to be here. You know, it's been quite a couple years for jazz bands like this. And you know, the time when we came together to record this album in May was the first time much anybody had played in a big band setting in a recording studio for more than 18 months. This is the first time we played together live.
Thank you.
doing an interview for this project, and I said, so this next piece is all about 2020, and the interviewer said, oh, everybody's got a 2020 piece. Okay. I don't care. This is my 2020 piece. No, 2020, it affected us all in many, many different ways. For me, there's this huge disconnect, and I've had this fascination. The last album we did was called Whispers on the Wind, but it was basically about Americana and the disconnect between what we value or say we value in terms of our heroes and our icons and what we kind of are. And I found that a fascinating subject to think about for that album, and I didn't really want to return to it for this album, but this piece kind of comes close because it's the same thing. During 2020, it felt like we had lost our way. And nothing seemed quite like it was, and we weren't sure, what was happening. At least that was my take on it. And so this is entitled American Noir, and it's very definitely related to the whole film noir sort of thing to me. It had a real kind of tangent there. And once I kind of got that and I knew what this piece was about, I couldn't help but thinking about the film score to one of my favorite film noir movies, Chinatown.
Yeah.
And Jerry Goldsmith wrote the score for that.
Yeah.
And it's just a phenomenal score. I've always loved it. And what I realized was, there's a little bit of this melody that kind of reminds me of that, but then that set me off. And so there's a middle piece in here, which I really part that I really quoted Jerry. So Chinatown was kind of influencing this whole thing too. American Noir.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark. Jim on the line next. Okay, this is one of those stories you're probably not going to believe, but it's really true. So this next piece is a piece I wrote with reminiscent of. This was bigger than my family. I wanted to write this piece a little bit about communities in general and what they mean to us. And I couldn't think of a better place to kind of put this thing is around the campfire. So I entitled it Sparks Fly. We get into the recording studio, and we're recording this, and all of a sudden, the recording manager comes flying out at me at the end of a half take and says, "You've got to evacuate everybody." I said, "What?" He says, "You need to get the band out now. The fire department's on its way. There's arcing on the roof. Things are jumping and there are sparks." And I said, "You're telling us the sparks are flying from the roof while we're recording Sparks Fly?" We spent 3 hours out with the firemen watching them go around and look for the fire. But anyway, so this is Sparks Fly.
Thank you. Thank you. Up on it too a little bit.
Danny Golly. We've got another guest we'd like to bring up. He was on our last album and a piece of it. It was a delight to, I can't say I really wrote for the instrument. I wrote the notes and he just made them work. He just made them absolutely shine. It's so great to have him back for this next piece. Gregoire Marais.
Thank you.
one more, but before we go, I want to introduce the folks in the band. On trumpet from Mike Alpacino.
Thank you.
you, there are CDs available at the gift shop. Coming up at 7:15, Arturo Alfaro is here with his Afro-Latin Jazz Ensemble. For those of you who would like to stay with us,